Micronations are cool, but also strange. For instance, this micronation in the United Kingdom called Lovely was created for a BBC comedy documentary by this guy. Although the documentary was called How to Start Your Own Country, he didn't actually manage to create anything. He went to New York to try and win the support of the United Nations, showing them that at its peak, 58,165 citizens were registered on the micronation's website, but he was rejected. I mean, let's be honest, the country had this for a flag, and it was clear to everyone that the guy was trolling. That being said, all my research on micronations led to the same thing. The leaders of these small countries are definitely messing with us. For instance, there is a micronation that is literally a rock. Yeah, that's it. Just a rock in a 6-inch box carried around everywhere by a woman. If you're nice, she might just let you touch the highest point in the country. She says she's trying to make a point that she doesn't necessarily believe in arbitrary borders and that a nation is really more about people getting along, heading in the same direction, and doing things together. One of the weirdest and most unique micronations in the world is the Republic of Malaysia. It borders the United States and was founded by this guy, His Excellency Kevin Baugh. Look at him, all proud of his country. It is headquartered at his home near Dayton, Nevada, where Malaysia has claimed itself a separate nation. It's about 180 miles away from San Francisco and about 325 miles from Las Vegas. Let's dive into the history of the Republic of Malaysia. Supreme Leader Kevin Baugh co-founded what would become the Republic of Malaysia on the 26th of May, 1977. Back then, the country was called the Grand Republic of Voldstein and was ruled by King James Spielman, who was the other founder, Kevin Baugh being only prime minister at the time. The country was then situated in Portland, Oregon. But because the reign of King James Spielman was tragically cut short when he grew tired of it and left, our main man, Kevin Baugh, became the leader. He renamed the country to the Republic of Malaysia, which is an adaptation of the Hawaiian word for harmony. He would carry the country wherever he went, and eventually bought some land in Dayton, Nevada. As he says, he liked it there because there were no bugs and it's nice and dry. Then His Majesty created a flag, blue representing strength in the clear desert sky, white for purity in the nearby mountains, and green to symbolize prosperity in the Malaysian landscape. As years passed by, the micronation reached a population of 32 people, but as Kevin Baugh says, the number could have been about 5,000 if he accepted all their citizenship requests. He even created the country's very own currency, which is called Valora, and intrinsically pegged to the value of a tube of Pillsbury cookie dough. If you're not sure how to spend your Valora, you can buy some special edition coins. Also, he managed to build a post office, a trading post, where this guy's in charge, and a customs shack, where Fred is responsible. You see what I meant when I said the micronation's founders were messing with us? And it doesn't end here. You see, every country has some form of governance. Most real countries are democratic, meaning that the supreme power is at some level in the hands of the general populace. But the Republic of Malaysia is a military dictatorship, which means that the military owns all the power and Kevin Baugh is the supreme dictator and a high-ranking military officer. The only real country which is currently ruled by a military dictator is Sudan, but unfortunately it is not ruled by Kevin. In the case of most micronations, they're ruled by a king, but Supreme Leader Kevin Baugh said he wasn't feeling the whole monarchy thing because he wanted a cool military uniform with a lot of medals, which he has now, so well done, Kevin. He rules the whole country and can do whatever he wants, like banning catfish, use of tobacco and plastic shopping bags, as should we all. But perhaps the most unique part about this strange micronation is that it is currently at war with East Germany. It's been this way since 1983 when the country was still called the Grand Republic of Voldstein. You see, back in 1983, East Germany still existed. The reason for the declaration of war is unknown because the declaration was lost, so everybody forgot. But the war waged on. In September 2018, the declaration was found. In it was the casus belli, which read that the war started because Kevin Baugh's sleep was disturbed when he was in Western Germany with the US Army. So, by the time the declaration was found, East Germany was long gone. That being said, the war ended because one side didn't really exist. So the war kind of ended in 1990, but not really, because of this tiny island near Cuba. You see, East Germany and Cuba were both communist. So in a gift of solidarity in the movement, Fidel Castro gave the island to East Germany in 1972, when Ernst Thälmann visited it. The uninhabited isle, which was previously named Cayo Blanco del Sur, is 9 miles long but only half a mile wide and it was renamed to Ernst Thälmann Island. Fast forward 18 years, during which the island was left uninhabited, East Germany fell and the island was forgotten. Nobody really cared about it, so in the documents when East Germany joined West Germany, this island was never mentioned, so technically it never joined West Germany, so technically it's still East German land, so technically East Germany still exists. But when a German newspaper remembered the island and wanted to make a visit, they were told by the Cuban government that the trade was symbolic, and that Fidel Castro never actually gave the island to East Germany, he only renamed it. That being said, the continued existence of East Germany is open to interpretation, and Kevin Baugh's interpretation is that he is still at war. If you think that this war is just a joke, take a look at his navy. He has massive ships prepared for war, which look like this. This is his Royal Navy. And to demonstrate his superior armaments, he even has nuclear weaponry, which looks like this, and it's being tested in his backyard. His Excellency Kevin Baugh said he would make a peace treaty with East Germany, but there's no one on the island. He even has a page on his website where you can support the war. So maybe he's doing all of this for the money, maybe he's just crazy, or maybe it's a combination of both. The Republic of Milosia apparently fought a 16-day war before it during 2006, which injured many people and even had one death, at least according to the country's official website. But what did you expect from a brutal dictator like Kevin Baugh?